Hello and welcome to BEA's Tech Time Live. Today we are going to be covering the 10TD900TR, telling you what its primary use is for. We're going to be utilizing first let me introduce myself. I'm Rob Rivero with BEA Technical, bypassing all this stuff. So I've worked for BEA going on 4 years, and I'm in the technical team. Along with me online is Jake DiBattista. If you have any questions, you can point those to the chat all so you can see each other's questions, and Jake will respond to those questions for you. So what we're going to be covering today is the 10TD900TR. So this is one of our radio transmitting devices. It's kind of unique because it runs off of 12 to 24 volts DC or AC or DC. And its primary use is to convert a push button with a 2-conductor and change it to a wireless device and utilize the 2-conductor for power. And we can change it to a wireless touchless device. We're going to be using the MS-08, the 10MS-08 today for that as well. And of course, anytime you get one of our TD or transmitting devices, you're going to need the 10RD900, the transmitting device, obviously going to activate your receiving device. So we're going to be utilizing a Record 8100 to show the entire process from beginning to end. Usually this is going to take about 15-20 minutes in total. So let us change this over. The first thing we're going to want to do is power down our operator for safety. So now, so changing this camera over here for wiring, we can see our 2-conductor that's currently being used for signaling. Tidy this up a little bit. And we're going to utilize this for the power to both our MS-08 for the power, and for our TD transmitting device, our TD900TR. So it really is as simple as this, taking all of our reds and all of our blacks, putting all of our blacks on the same wire nut, and taking all of our reds on the same wire nut. Now, the last thing we're gonna do, I'm gonna need a couple of wire nuts for this, is we're gonna take our white and green from our MS-08, and we will activate our transmitter with the relay, a signal output from the MS-08. So now essentially when you wave your hand on the MS-08, it's going to activate the transmitting device, which is going to therefore signal the RD900 and activate your door. So I have a little screwdriver over here. So essentially, you'll have your cut in box and everything. And in a perfect world, you would have everything already set up. Because of my cut in box, I'm going to be using the single gang faceplate that comes with it. That just snaps right on. You do have a few adjustments on this, you may know, for the distance. And you do have a normally open, normally closed back here if you needed it on the transmitting device. So, there we go there. So this is the process for changing a switch, a push button, to a touchless. Not very difficult, not very time consuming in real time. Now I'm going to switch the angle. You'll switch back to this camera, Jonathan. So now I'm going to switch our angle to our operator so I can go over wiring this operator to the 900 and show you guys a close-up of that. Let's go. If you can switch to this, Jonathan, this angle. There we go. Being a little bit stubborn. There we go. Perfect. Okay. So now, on the Record 8100, which we're utilizing for this demonstration, 1 and 2 is power. The common is power on here, so all we really need to do, since 1 is power and 2 is a signal, we're going to change this to 1 and 3, which that is going to be literally power. We're now providing power to our touchless switch and our TV900TR, sorry. And now I'll land this on 6 because that is the 0 volts for our RD, any one of the on this particular operator, any of the 0 volts will do for our ground. Now our white, since 24 volts is the common and the power, terminal 4 is at 24 volts. So the green is our signal, which goes back to terminal 2, which was our signal input for our push button. Now we're going to utilize the receiving device. We can fit it in here. There we go. And voila. So now we power up our device, our operator. You see we got power on there. The first thing I usually do is clear this out. To clear out the RD900, you'd hold for 10 red blinks. And then you'll see the blue LED blink, which means it's clear. It's completely clear. Okay, so now we're ready to, let me not play with this. We're ready to learn the touchless switch. So in order to do that, what we're gonna do is push our button until it's red, just about a second, swipe once, swipe twice, and you can see the blue LED. That means that it took and it has learned. And obviously the touchless switch is functioning. So now, just for the sake of safety, I'm gonna tuck my wires away up here, put my receiver up here. And so let's switch back over to the other camera. let our door close, and let's check our distance with our touchless switch, because again, the distance is a variable. We can adjust that. The ANSI standards state that 12 inches makes it comply. Anything 12 inches or less complies, nothing over 12 inches, to maintain a knowing act. So I think we're right at about 8-9 inches. And voila, we have completed from top to bottom a very simple conversion from a two conductor push button to a power line that supplies power for our radio control and our touchless switch. If you had larger jobs, this would be ideal for it. I don't know if there's any questions that anybody has. Jake, do you got any questions anybody has?
Doesn't look like you got any questions yet. Let's give it a minute.
Okay. Let that laser flat scan close the door because it's seeing me. And again, the MS-08, 10 MS-08, the 10 TV 900TR, very simple solution for this type of application, and the RD900, the 10 RD900 is our radio control.
Hey Rob, do you want to discuss why you cannot wire a 900 or a 433 straight to a strike or a maglock?
Yeah, that's a great idea. So the relay that are built on the RD900 is a resistive load rating of 1 amp. So resistive load meaning door controls. It's designed to signal a door control, a resistive load. Resistive load is not an inductive load. An inductive load would be like a strike, a mag lock, something that has some pull to it. We recommend like a BR3X or a relay. This will drive a relay, which is a coil of a relay, a resistive load, quite easily. So it'd be safe and it'll give you, basically it's going to save you a callback. You don't want to keep going back out to a job site because you're using the wrong products. It makes you look bad, makes your customer angry. So really not a good idea to use the 1 amp rated resistive load relay that's built on the RD900s. So I think we're good. No questions.
No questions, but we got some Q&A's. So David McBriar was thanking you for a very good, quick demonstration. Can we get your tech working for us in the field this efficiently? Awesome.
Well, you know, so I've been a tech in the field since the mid-90s as an electrician and a technician with door systems. One of the most convincing things that we can do here is show you in real time what we can do on a job site. This isn't, you know, like me being a genius. Any of your techs can follow this. This is a very simple process, very quick. I'm actually describing it all, give you kind of some insight into how it goes and what product we're using. So if I came up to a door, you can imagine I could probably do this in 5 minutes or less once you get a pattern down. This could be a big moneymaker. And once you install the TD900TR, you will never have to go back to the job site because it doesn't use batteries. Battery technology is going to be great in the future, but right now, when you use battery technology with this many devices, it's going to wear that battery down. Your battery is going to be worn down. And I've heard the horror stories from anything from 2 months to 6 months when they say the rating on these system battery operated systems are 1 year, 2 years. That's if you wave your hand and use it once a month, you know, once a day, something like that. Realistically, this is a much better option. Another thing you should know about that 900TR is you don't have to think outside the box. If you do have a push button going in an odd location and you want to use radio controls, you can do that. I have installed this out in the field. Instead of utilizing pulling a wire to your operator, you can also use a wall wart plug-in and pull power someplace close to where the button is And it sometimes, and not in this instance, but sometimes your button is 12 feet away and it's more efficient to put a power supply near the push button and simply install this device, and you don't have to pull a wire at all. You have a wall wart plug-in close to your push button, wire again, voila, you're done.
Okay, Rob, so we have three things that we might want to discuss. Sure. We're going to start with Steve Prokovich. He mentioned the BR2900, if you wanted to discuss that a bit in comparison with the 900 megahertz receiver itself.
Yeah, so that's an excellent question. So the BR2900 has two double-pole, double-throw relays built onto it. It's essentially BR2 as versus our BR3 module. But the beauty of the BR2900 is that it's wireless. And it's a hub as well, because it has an input on it. So if you had a push button that was close to your door and you wanted to hardwire that push button, say to a security system, you could actually signal that wireless hub to open your door via a hardwire. And you can use your touchless switches, your transmitter devices. Not only can you use your transmitter devices, you can use one on the inside that will work 24/7, and you can tell the other one to be on a securable input. So you could put an day and night input to your BR2900 and tell that wireless push button on the outside to function at certain times of day and to stop functioning at other times of the day. And not to limit its ability, it has the two double pull, double throw relays that are rated for 3 amps at 40 volts, I believe. And those are for inductive loads. Those are for the mag locks and for the strikes inductive loads. So we make heavier duty specifically because it's designed for locks. We use a lot in industrial products. At the same time that it unlocks the door, it could have a light or a sounder that tells the door is unlocked. Industrial products, if you're going to pull out a garage, it will have a sounder because there's a walkway right outside the door, things like that. But it's an excellent device for separating out and partitioning all your inputs. One you want to work wireless 24/7, one you want to turn on and off with the day and night, and another hardwired.
So one of the things we were asked is how many transmitters can be used with each of those, the 433 and the 900 receivers?
74 will work on the 900, but now that would be in on the rolling codes from, I believe it's 908 to 918 is the rolling codes for security. But if you wanted to, if you had a warehouse or a school where you wanted all of the doors to function, and instead of having to go up and go through the learn process that I showed you, pushing the button, swiping your hand, we do have on a TD transmitting device 900 universal. Now, what you would do is you would learn that transmitting device into the 900. On the BR2900 that Mr. Prokovich was asking about, we have a universal mode on that. So essentially, if you called us and said, I need 1,000 doors with 10,000 transmitters, we can essentially accommodate that. You should know that once you do that, all of those, they no longer have to be learned in. Once you learn them into the 900, or you turn on the switch for the BR2900, they all function. So I would not recommend using it for a security device at that point. It's just for the convenience of having wireless operation. Students in all the bathrooms in a college, if you had handicapped students, you could hand them all, instead of going and learning one, if they lose it, you can give them another one. In a warehouse atmosphere, if somebody drives over it with a forklift, you can just give them another one. You don't have to go through the learning process. Big time saver, unlimited amount of transmitters. But if you put the rolling codes in on the day-to-day basis, 74. It will take 74 transmitters.
Okay, so for the 900 megahertz retrofit, can you install the other transmitter that uses two AAA batteries if that's all they have in the field?
No, that's a great question. The one thing that I failed to mention, I wanted to remember, the TD, what we would call that is the TD transmitting device 900 PB, push button. That one comes with a little AA pack for batteries. That AA pack is 3-volt system. That is not, if you put that, cut the wires off of that and put it on 12 to 24 volts, that thing is going to fry. Okay. That is a different device. There are components in the 900 TR that make it capable of suiting 12 to 24 volts AC or DC. They are two different animals. Do not get them confused. You cannot cut the batteries off of the PB, the push button with the two tags on it, and the battery pack built onto it. Two totally different devices. Don't get them confused and don't try and intermix them. Any other questions? Let me think. There's so many possibilities with this, and I've been asked to accommodate so many different applications. Applications. But if I had one thing to say, if you want longevity for a system, this wireless system that's pulling power, you will never have to go back to it once you install it. It pulls power forever. It's just like a hardwired device. That's the beauty of it. Do the other systems that are battery operated, when BEA does come out with one someday, hopefully, they will have a battery system, some of the new solid state battery packs and other types of battery packs, the technology is going to be great. Hopefully we'll use those when they're available and when we can put out a product worth using, but we don't want to create jobs for people just going around changing batteries, really.
Is there a double gang box option?
Well, with the MS-08, it's a very versatile button. Switch. It does come with, now this one is not NEMA rated, by the way. The MS-08 is not NEMA rated. We do have some NEMA rated switches, but this one comes with a weather resistant seal for it that goes behind. You can see the design was just to snap it in place. So this has a double gang and a single gang that comes with it. It even comes with a little adapter plate. I keep these because if you're an electrician out in the field, these are very handy for the handy boxes and such that are don't accommodate. So you can make this into a double game quite simply. And this all comes in this kit. So it's a great little kit that comes together. The MS-11 would be the magic switch that I would recommend if you had a weather resistant, weather concerns. That one is NEMA 4 rated IP65, very durable. An excellent switch. Also, you can see that this one is ideal for lit areas, but if you have a dark hallway or an entryway to a building, it's kind of dark and can be not seen. The MS-11 has a lit up face to it, so it lets you know that there's a switch there. That comes in very handy on those applications. The MS-08 does not have the lit face, so that's another consideration. And the I do have a bollard around here someplace, but these, we have put these in the bollards. As long as you add the two conductor for the 900 transmitter TR, the transmitter retro kit, you could utilize that quite simply on a bollard. So with the combination of products that we have with the Magic Switch series, these touchless systems are becoming a very huge market, very in demand, and it actually serves a very good purpose for all of our society. As everybody knows with COVID-19, this has become a big issue. This is our resolve to taking larger facilities that don't want to dedicate a engineer to go around changing batteries. They want to put it in and never see it again. This is our solution, and it is an excellent solution. That being said, you can see that the installation time is really quick. We covered that plus some. Any further questions?
I think that's a wrap.
Excellent. Well, I really appreciate anybody and everybody who came and watched our little presentation here, BEA's Tech Time Live. And Jake will probably be conducting the next one, which I'm looking very forward to. It won't be in my garage because I'm in Portland, Oregon. It'll be in Pittsburgh in Jake's garage. So thanks everybody for attending. I really appreciate it. It means a lot.